Ici Dutch Robinson.
Et bienvenue au spécial Marvin Gaye sur les ondes de Musique Plus.
Bye!
Eh bien, c'était Let's Get It On, la première chanson qu'on entend dans la pièce de théâtre Dream of a Lifetime, l'histoire de Marvin Gaye, qui joue présentement au Club Soda. Dutch Robinson, qui interprète le rôle principal, celui de Marvin Gaye, nous donne des frissons pendant la durée du spectacle. Avec une voix absolument incomparable, une sincérité avec ses textes, il nous permet vraiment de vivre la parfaite illusion. La pièce de théâtre raconte les hauts et les bas de la vie de Marvin Gaye, ainsi que nous présente ses plus gros succès, comme par exemple Let's Get It On, également tout l'album de What's Going On, I Heard It Through the Grapevine, Save the Children, Sexual Healing et plusieurs autres. Pour tous ceux de vous qui ont toujours aimé la musique de Marvin Gaye ou pour tous ceux de vous qui aimeraient découvrir la musique de Marvin Gaye, ne manquez pas ce spectacle présentement au Club Soda jusqu'à dimanche soir prochain. Billets disponibles au comptoir Tikitron et aussi au Club Soda.
How does Dutch Robinson, the singer, relate to Dutch Robinson, the actor? Because this is really primarily your acting debut.
It does not compute.
Does not compute? So how do you work? How do you work the text? How did the text become part of you or make part of your character? What did you do?
I just lived the way I've been through this stuff. I know what drugs are, and I know what alcohol is, mm-hmm. and I know what abuse is, and I know what to have a bad family and to be without a marriage and to have to walk away from children and stuff like that. I mean, I come from a black community in New York. I grew up with that kind of stuff, so it's kind of, this is why I'm here, I guess, because I was able to get past that.
Did you ever meet Marvin?
Yeah, I had a chance to meet him.
What was your first impression when you met him, and where did you meet him?
Well, I opened up for him at Radio City Music Hall, and I didn't really get to see him, his character there, other than being on stage, mm-hmm. but in little places like in Detroit and places like that, when we would come to town, you know, little places that you go to and you mm-hmm. meet up with other entertainers and things like that, I had a chance to be around. Marvin was very quiet and very peace-loving, and very calm, you know, very secretive.
Because my papa, he was a drinker. When he drank, he enjoyed kicking my butt. So, it didn't do any good. I'd go back out there and he'd kick my butt some more, and I'd go back out there and he'd kick it some more. See, that's kind of what our relationship was all about.
Mercy, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be. What about this overcrowded land? How much more can this land stand?
The lyrics that attracted you to his sound, was it the music?
Marvin writes like I do.
Which means what?
He writes about the things that happen in his life. He doesn't have a formula. He goes through the pain and then he puts it out on paper. If he never writes a song, it's because he hasn't gone through enough series of anxieties and disappointments mm-hmm. and happiness and all those things that you need to put together a good song. He wrote like that. He didn't have a formula. He wasn't the guy who sit down and just say, well, what am I going to write about today? He wrote about his wife and ex-wife and ex-girlfriend mm-hmm. and the dog and, mm-hmm. you know, but he put it in a perspective where everybody could understand it.
Now, I know that you were instrumental mm-hmm. in steering the writing of the play in the right direction. You told Dwight Bakke who he should speak to. Who did you think was the person who can give the most reliable information about Marvin?
Well, Tony Sylvester, who I'm producing right now, the main ingredient.
Yes.
I got Dwight in touch with Tony, and Tony let Dwight talk to people out in L.A. who were like Harvey Fuqua, and then Cat Dyson was very instrumental in finding out information through Smokey Robinson and Marvin's ex-manager. Why don't you call Cat over and ask her?
Okay. Harvey Fuqua, who brought Marvin to Motown, was working with Smokey, and Marilyn Friedman was also working with Smokey, and she's Marvin's last manager, so this was great. And as it turned out, a college buddy of mine was Marvin's last musical director. He also played guitar on the Sexual Healing, the album, and all that, Gordon Banks.
And when I get that feeling, I want sexual healing. Sexual healing is good for me. I want to tell you a little story. My name and my friends, we standing on our favorite butt kicking corner, you know? And all of a sudden, this guy appears. First, he was just standing there. Then all of a sudden, he jumps right in the middle, takes over the lead section from my buddy. We was pissed, but he was good. He had some moves that make you feel like fainting just watching, you know? And the singing wasn't too bad either. So just about when we're ready to stop moving, stop singing and everything, he stops, turns to me and says, "Oh, hey, my name is Harvey Fuqua. You probably heard of me from the Moon Glows. Well, I'm singing at Louisa's tonight, so why don't you guys come on down and check me out?" That was it. He was gone.
To find a way to bring some loving, loving here today. Oh,
pick it back.
The feeling of America when What's Going On came out, you know, about, you know, black people finally coming to terms with a lot of things governmentally, with their rights, you know, with directions, and not wanting to be a part of the Vietnam thing, and standing up for their own and feeling good about it. You know, so that kind of made a statement, like, okay, we're in the inner city, you know, we may be the underprivileged as such, but we are stars in our own right. So I think that it was a serious contribution.
There's always that pressure of being the black performer instead of being the performer. You know, you have to go from R&B music to pop music, and the white performer can go directly to pop music. So black performers don't get a chance to be heard like they're supposed to. I would like to change that, and if I don't, then maybe he'll change it, or somebody else will. But you know, somebody's got to change.
Papa had a thing for preaching gloom and doom. Show you what I mean.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Do you hear me? Doctrines of devils. And this was me. Some sexual healing, but I wasn't getting any.
You're my medicine. Open up and let me in. Oh, sugar, can't wait till you operate. Oh,
wait.
what was their reaction when they found out that a play was going to be written about?
Everybody's happy because nobody's really done any kind of serious theater piece other than, of course, doing a collage of some music or you know, featuring a weekend, playing all of his stuff, or you know, putting footage. I think they're talking PBS, putting footage together of things that he had done. But you know, as far as theater, somebody, you know, taking it to the theatrical stage, no one's done it. So Motown phoned Black Theater Workshop and said,
"Really, they did?
Oh, yes.
They really did?
Oh, yes.
Do they want to sort of see the show?"
Well, they're going to come.
What do you hope the audience will walk away with?
Feeling that the memory of a great singer has been, you know, presented to them in a good light, and that what he did leave us is the gift and the legacy of the music that he recorded, and hopefully that we represent it properly.
This song that Marvin has, he wrote his own eulogy,
yes.
Dream of a Lifetime.
Yeah.
Every time I get to that song, just thinking about that song, I don't even want to sing that song because it's like singing the end. You know, I don't want to do Marvin's songs. After I do this play, I want to forget about this play. I just want to do this song, this play, and after it's all over, I want to be able to go home because it's been hard already. Just trying to fill his shoes.
Thank God for my wonderful life. Thank God for my wonderful life.
Where would you like to see the show go?
I'd like to see it go where they didn't think I'd make it at, New York.
Eh bien, j'espère que l'émission de ce soir a su vous plaire. Je vous rappelle encore une fois que le spectacle aura lieu jusqu'à dimanche soir prochain au Club Soda, mettant en vedette le superbe Dutch Robinson. La pièce s'intitule Marvin, Dream of a Lifetime, et les billets sont disponibles dans tous les comptoirs Tiquitron ainsi que le Club Soda. À ne pas manquer!
I feel the salt air. I have a reason to be whole. All the wonders that never cease to be. You're as timeless.
For Rita McNeil always was and still is beside the Bradora Lakes in Big Pond, Cape Breton Island. From an early age, Rita had a talent for singing, and her parents would have her sing whenever they could. As a teenager, all she wanted to do was be a singer, but Rita, she was shy. They say that at her music lessons, her teacher sang more than she did. At the age of 17, she left home for Ontario with a dream of becoming a performer. It was the beginning of a long and difficult journey.
And I never again will go down underground. It's a work of mine. I've been down underground. I swear to God, if I ever see the sun,
sloppy, icky, can't get enough. Mucky,
yucky, gooey,
If it's soft and clean and nice, stay away, take my advice. Find some puddle filled with mud, wallow in that filthy flood. Ooh-wee.
Gooey, sticky stuff.
Sloppy,
and you can't get enough.
Mucky,
yucky, goobery gum. How I love that gummy junk. Squishy, squashy, between my toes.
Boogers,
boogers up my nose.
That's
holy moly, soap and water. Hating,
scary,
hairy, and grossitating.
Sticking to the walls and floors. Fingerprints on shelves and drawers. Grimy, grubby, so much fun. But my work just begun. Ooey,
gooey, sticky stuff.
Sloppy,
icky, can't get enough.
Mucky,
yucky, goobery gum. How I love that gummy junk. Squishy,
squashy,
between my toes.
Boogers,
boogers up my nose.
Holy moly, soap and water. Hating, scary,
hairy,
and grossitating. Ooey,
gooey, sticky stuff.
Sloppy,
icky, can't get enough.
Mucky,
yucky, goobery gum. How I love that gummy junk.
Ooey,
gooey, sticky stuff.
Sloppy,
icky, can't get enough.
Mucky,
yucky, goobery gum.
How I love that gummy junk. Yeah.
You do the bass. Look at that face. That's, woo, excuse me, death. I'm gonna show you something. I'm gonna show you something that you're gonna have fun with. Show you how to beat on yourself.
What? You mean hit ourselves?
Yeah, and have fun.
How have fun doing it?
Have fun doing it. I guarantee you'll have fun.
I don't believe you.
I guarantee you'll have fun.
Okay, show us.
Okay?
Yeah, show us.
Look at that face.
Yeah, show us.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, can I sit here for a minute?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to sit right here. I'm going to show you.
Okay.
I like this when I was a kid.
Oh, I'm a kid. I can learn,
yeah,
too.
I'm a kid still. I like to be a kid. I love to be a kid.
You're a big man now.
Yeah, but I'm still a kid. Don't worry about it.
Now watch. He plays too.
Watch this.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. He's going to hit himself. It makes like music.
That's right. Uh-huh. Like, wow, a march. Like a march.
Wow.
Yeah. You want to try it?
Okay.
Okay. You can try it. You can try it out there too. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four.
Ow, 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 ow.
Oh. 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 Yeah. I forgot to tell you one thing. You gotta put your hand in a cup like that.
Oh. Okay. Let's try it again.
You put your hand in the cup. Ready?
Yeah.
And I know we can do this. You can do it too. Ready? No problem. Ready?
Go.
One, two, three, four. You got it?
It's
you got it? Yeah, man.
Wow.
You having fun?
Wow. That's the show.
You know what?
Next show? Wow, Chansley, what are you playing with that stuff for?
Because it's icky, googly, guck. And it's fun.
I don't like it.
I love it. Here, try it.
No, no, don't touch me with it. Gross, 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 no, no.
What's going on?
Yeah. Hi,
Dutch. Hi, how you doing? What's happening?
Dutch, she's playing with icky stuff.
What is this stuff? Oh, this is great. Oh, I love this stuff.
You think it's great?
Yeah, man. Look at that stuff. Isn't that fun? You like stuff like this? I love to play with stuff like this. Have you ever played with
this?
No,
it's gross.
No? What's wrong with her? Does she know anything about this?
No.
Well, we should tell her a little bit something about this. You don't want to know?
Okay.
You want? She's got to know.
Okay.
Ooey.
Gooey.
Sticky stuff. Mucky.
Icky, can't get enough.
Mucky.
Yucky.
Gooey gunk. How I love that gummy junk. Ooey.
Gooey.
Sticky stuff. Sloppy.
Icky,
can't get enough. Mucky.
Yucky.
Gooey gunk. How I love that gummy junk. If it's soft, smooth, and nice, stay away, take my advice. Find a puddle filled with mud. Wallow in that filthy flood. Ooey.
Gooey. Sticky stuff.
Sloppy.
Yucky. Can't get enough.
Mucky.
Yucky.
Gooey gunk. How I love that gummy junk. Squishy.
Squishy.
Between my toes. Boogers.
Boogers. Up my nose.
Holy moly, soap and water, hating, scary, hairy and
grossitating.
Come on. Sticking to the walls and floors, sticking to shelves and drawers. Grimy, grubby, so much fun. Now I know I've just begun. Ooey,
gooey, sticky stuff.
Sloppy,
I can't get enough.
Mucky.
Googly
gunk. Oh, how I love that gummy junk. Squishy.
Squishy
between my toes. Oogers.
Buggers
up my nose. Holy moly, soap and water. Hating, scary, hairy, and
grossitating.
Oh, it's not that gross.
Sticky stuff. Sloppy.
Icky, can't get enough.
Mucky.
Yucky.
Googly gunk. How I love that gummy junk. Ooey.
Gooey.
Sticky stuff. Sloppy.
Yucky. Can't get enough.
We have to go
Mucky.
To the
show. Oh.
Where
are we going?
See ya.
Well, we can keep on playing.
I like it now.
What's the other one?
I like it.
I love it.
We have an artist on the show today. I guarantee no matter what you are doing, if you can hear my voice, follow it into your living room and have a seat because you will not want to miss this performer. Dutch Robinson has joined us today. He's been living in this part of the world for a couple of years, but he's a huge talent. He was born in the States, in the Bronx. He's been all over. He's played with tons of people. His songwriting credits include working with Hall & Oates, Nancy Wilson, Cirque du Soleil. He's worked with Billy Joel, B.B. King, you name it, Aretha Franklin. His voice is just unbelievable. To have a talent like this in our part part of the world is so incredible, and you don't want to miss him. So there's many opportunities to see him. In fact, you'll be able to see him on the Harborfront stage during the gala opening of the new casino, as well on May 19th for the kickoff to the Memorial Cup party, and more importantly, with his new CD, Thursday, May 11th at the new casino, he'll be launching the new CD, which we'll show you. Here it is. It's a great release party. This is called Come On Home, and it's featuring the High Strung Trio, recorded in Toronto about 4 months ago, but never officially released till he came to God's country. Yeah. So here he is, the God of Singing himself, with a tune he wrote called If I Can't Have You. Dutch Robinson.
If I could buy the things I wanted most, I'd cast them all aside just to come sit with you and hold you close and listen to your sigh. If I could buy some time, I'd buy it all, a lot more than we need. Share all the things I want to share.
Thank you.
gotta get those hairs back down off the back of my neck. How many octaves do you think you have in there?
Oh, I sing about 4 or 5.
Yeah, about 4 or 5, I'd have to say. Dutch Robinson on BT today. Good luck with all your endeavors coming up, and stay
you.
Around. One more tune. Can we ask you for one more a little
Anytime.
Later? Ah, the man's a prince. We're gonna take a break here on BT. We're all gonna relax. And maybe we'll just let you sing for the rest of the show. Well, we gotta cook.
We're gonna do Killing Me Softly.
Wait till you hear Dutch Robinson.
Oh,
yeah. I felt he'd found my letters and read each one out loud, yeah. I prayed that he would finish, but he just kept right on drumming the paint with his finger.
One time.
I'm sorry, Dutch, but applause isn't enough. We are not worthy. You are the man. He's going to be back with some more music for us on Breakfast Television. Dutch Robinson! Woo! Here is a great CD that's out now that Dutch Robinson is on, just being released in the metro area. It is some great jazz. You've got to hear it. Here's a tune from Dutch Robinson now on Breakfast Television.
I want to tell you a little bit about my life, you know, give you an idea of where I come from. Mama used to tell me, she didn't have nothing. Nothing's got her. Come on, help me out, folks. I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said no, I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said no, I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said I know I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. A friend in need is a friend indeed, and a friend in need is a friend in debt. So the only friend I've got, Mama told me, was me, yeah. I remember every Sunday morning, me and Mama, we put our best clothes on and we'd go to church just to get down on our knees to pray. Sunday was the Lord's day. Preacher man, getting all he can from the poor folks' hands. Now he was quite a man, can you understand? He said, Jesus loves your son. Well, I'll be a son of a gun. So I prayed and prayed each and every day for a brand new sleigh on Christmas Day. No way, that sleigh never did come. Said I know, Mama say, I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said yeah, I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Nothing's got me. Boo, 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 boo. Boo, 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 boo. In a little time, started drinking wine with a friend of mine. Now we were doing just fine, having good time all the time, me and this friend of mine. Oh, but I couldn't cope. I started smoking that dope. Mama lost all hope and faith in me. Robbery wasn't me, but the man took me and this friend of mine. Change, got no time for this so-called friend of mine. Said I love I ain't got nothing, nothing's got me. Said I ain't got nothing, nothing's got me. Said I ain't got nothing, nothing's got me. Said I ain't got nothing, nothing's got me. On final release, the man told me, let the cut date hit you where the good Lord put you. Go on, son, try to make a new life if you can. I'll be damned if I didn't. Find me a wife, start a new life. Had a couple of kids, so good. Lucky me, started out with a ready-made family, yeah. Coming home early, snatching that girl out of sight. She had the food on.
we got into a big fight. The woman told me,
that's all right.
Out of sight. Let me tell you, I don't need you, boy. Find me a new toy. I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me. Said I ain't got nothing. Nothing's got me.
Said I
ain't got nothing.
It has been an honor to have you on the show. Would you please come back again?
I'm the music man. You're the breakfast man.
Oh, and never the twain shall meet.
Oh, I love it.
We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more Breakfast Television. Just 2 minutes. Two, three.
Oh, yeah.